Hi, I'm Pastor Goodman.
And this is the Largely Catechized Life.
So baptism is the beginning of faith, but it doesn't just stop there. It's actually connected to everything else. Baptism is the beginning of your life in Christ, so much so that ancient churches would put the baptismal font right at the door because that's how you got into the church. That's the foundational point of membership. That is on the thing on which everything else is built to this day. If you want to be a member of our churches, it's a requirement that you be baptized to actually hold membership. But more than just where your name goes on which piece of paper, baptism actually changes how we hear God's own word. We receive God's word now as children, not as those far off, not as those in darkness, but as those in light. Baptism actually changes how we would look at the scriptures because we receive them in promise now, because we are named heirs of that promise. Baptism changes how we even see our congregation so that even though it's just a whole bunch of sinners stuffed in a box and trying to get along, I can now see them as brothers and sisters in Christ, those for whom Christ has bled and died. And it also changes how we deal with our sins too. In the Large Catechism, Luther writes, and here you see that baptism, both in its power and signification, comprehends also the third sacrament, which has been called repentance, as it is really nothing else than baptism. For what else is repentance but an earnest attack upon the old man, that his lusts be restrained, and entering upon a new life? Therefore, if you live in repentance, you walk in baptism, which not only signifies such a new life, but also produces, begins, and exercises it. See, all of Christian life is baptism. Old Adam daily dies, new man daily rises, and we find it all in the Christ who died and rose for us. Baptism unites us to that Jesus, his death, his resurrection, so that as we interact with our own, well, old Adam, as I confront all of my sins, repentance just, it's not a measurement of how sorry you are. It's about where you look for truth. That's what produces the contrition, the feeling sorry. That's what begins the struggle to do more. But that's also what exercises the grace that takes shelter in God's promise and finds comfort. See, repentance flows out of baptism because in baptism, we can actually stand close enough to the law to tell the truth about what it calls us, because we can stand underneath the gospel and what that tells us. God is for us. See, that means repentance is simply an acknowledgement of truth. The law is true. That means that I am a sinner who needs forgiveness and help. And the gospel is true. Christ daily and richly forgives all my sins and the sins of all believers. And on the last day, he will raise me and all the dead and give eternal life to me and all believers in Christ. This is most certainly true. And in all of it, I can actually see the glory of God's word now, because I'm not reading it as one for whom he threatens. I'm reading it as a baptized child of God, for whom he has promised life and salvation in the forgiveness of sins won for us in Christ Jesus our Lord. Baptism changes everything.